Hello, this is Dr. Adam Kopsky here at Advanced Rehab and Medical in Jackson, Tennessee, and I'm coming on here to discuss our topic that we have this week. And so each week, if I hadn't told you before, we have these little handouts here. When you come into the rehab area where you may see George over to the right, we have these little handouts, and over by the adjusting area where you can grab them. And so this is one of the first ones we actually have that where I'm going to discuss some of the research, okay? And it actually goes into, maybe many of you are wondering about the safety of chiropractic care, and even if you've heard, does chiropractic cause stroke? So I'm going to briefly just talk about that, and this handout does a great job of going over it. So I just wanted to go over a few the main points that these research studies have found on that topic. So first off, some media outlets have highlighted that an estimate of 1 in 5.7 million chiropractic adjustments indicate stroke. And if any of those you're wondering about that, we actually dive to the literature to look closer. And so on this front page, there's actually four studies here that they did, where actually two Cassidy studies found that there is no evidence of excess risk of stroke with chiropractic care. And even further, they went on to say that there was no evidence of excess risk of stroke with chiropractic care versus going to your primary care doctor. So when you hear those things about safety, we should really be diving into the literature to really say that. A lot of it's hearsay, but if we go to the evidence and really look at the literature, then we can really let that speak for itself. On this back side, you'll see here that they really have a fascinating point and analogy that I'd like to share. When you see about a stroke, okay, and signs and symptoms of stroke, a lot of times it's very hard because you may have neck pain, and a lot of times where you go when you have neck pain, you go to your doctor. And so whether that be your chiropractor or your medical doctor, you actually find that, of course, that risk is going to go up, because when you have signs and symptoms of stroke, you're going to go to the doctor, and then you pinpoint, oh, you had a stroke when you saw those chiropractors or the MDs. But they had one analogy that really took home with me was one where they talked about if you had heartburn and indigestion, and your doctor prescribed you a medication for that indigestion, and then maybe you went on for a couple weeks and didn't get any signs of improvement, and then it was later found out that you had stomach cancer. So are we going to blame the medication as the cause of the reasoning of why you got stomach cancer? And the answer would be no. And so chiropractic can be like that. It's not that it was the cause of the stroke, but maybe an impending non-contributory problem of a developing crisis and problem that got overlooked. And so that's why always when patients come in, we do a very thorough exam and we get to the root cause of what's really causing it. Because at the end of the day, our job as physicians is not to treat everyone that comes in, but it's rather to diagnose them and get the help that they need. And so one thing, if you're ever leery about the safety, the last point I'll talk about is they actually did a study on the safety of chiropractic and actually found those that visit a chiropractor had a 76% reduction of risk of injury than those that saw their primary care doctor. So when you hear things about the safety of chiropractic and stroke, we should all be diving in and looking at the research and let the research speak for itself. So when we practice that way by evidence, we can therefore get the best outcomes for the patients and increase safety. So I hope this was informative. So please come in and see us, and be sure to grab a handout. Thank you very much.